Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, your one-stop shop for everything fabric. I'm your host, Patrick LeBlanc, and I'm here today with super user Gregor Brunner. Gregor, tell us about who you are and what you do.
Well, thanks for having me. So I'm the CEO of Measure Killer, which is a tool for Power BI and Fabric. We're based in Switzerland. And yeah, I'm happy to be here.
Okay, so today you're here to tell us about all things security with Microsoft Fabric.
Exactly, we have different levels of security. It starts at the item level, we go up to the workspace level, and then we even have the tenant level.
Okay, so enough of all this talking, Gregor. You know what we like to do, let's head to my laptop.
All right, so when we end up in the Fabric portal, we can see here on the left that we have our workspaces. That's how everything is organized. Think of it like a folder. So if I open up this workspace here, I can see all the items that are inside that workspace. So here you can see we have notebooks, right? We have pipelines, warehouses, and so on. Also some reports. And if I want to grant access to somebody, I can click here and I can go to the permissions. Here we are. And here I could add a user or a group, right?
And so, okay, but that's a lot of work. I ain't be honest with you, right? If I'm working in Fabric, you saw this workspace. There's lots and lots of items in this workspace, and it would not be very efficient of me to go through each one of those items. I'm not lazy. I'm just really efficient, Gregor. And so there's got to be an easier way or a faster way for me to do this.
True. So if we don't want to go grant permissions on item level, we can go to the manage access part in the workspace. You can see it here on the top right. So that way we can grant access to...
Let's say John Doe.
You have a John Doe in your tenant?
Yeah, he works for me.
Oh, wow.
There you
never met that guy. So now we can grant him different levels of access to that workspace.
Okay, so I see four different roles here. I see an admin, a member, and a contributor, and a viewer. If it was me, right, if I'm developing things out and I wanna share content with someone, but I wanna secure all this content down so they don't make changes, which will be the best access level I should give them?
The safe one is the viewer one. That's read only, right?
Yeah.
Contributor, you could already remove stuff. You can get into trouble.
Yep.
And then member, you can even add new people. To the workspace.
Got it. And then as an admin, we could take it to the next level, right?
Exactly.
Do everything. Now, this is great, right? So we went down from the item level, we went to the workspace level, but I'm an administrator, right? I want control of everything. I want to see everything everyone is doing. How do we solve that problem?
Yeah, so if you're looking at multiple workspaces or potentially your whole tenant, you have to go up here to the admin portal. Mm-hmm. And that is only available if you're a Fabric admin.
Gotcha.
And then you can do all your settings here, or you can even grant yourself access to a workspace you don't have access to.
Wow, so now I got the cheat code to get access to everything in my Fabric capacity. That was a whirlwind tour of all things security and Fabric. If you wanna talk to Gregor, if you have any questions, comments about what we talked about in this video, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button. And as always, from Gregor, Swetha, Microsoft, and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday.
Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive in the Microsoft Fabric.